Sum is one of the most frequently used formulas in Google Sheets and Excel. However, sometimes it can cause double counting. That can easily be fixed by using the subtotal function instead. So we have our personal budget worksheet here and we want to sum the expenses by each category. So I'm going to use the sum function and add up the subtotal for each of the category for home, food, utilities, and transportation. The way to do it, you just do equal sum and then you specify the range. Now, if you try to copy and paste the formula, be aware that so some of the categories are smaller, they might only have two rows instead of four, so you might have to adjust the range. Now, if I'm going to use the sum function to calculate the grand total, but the sum function not only includes the single categories, it also includes the subcategory totals. So what happens is it double counts. To fix this, you might try to do it manually and select each of the subcategory totals in your formula, but that's tedious and it can also lead to mistakes. By using the subtotal functions, we can solve this problem. What we are going to do, instead of using the sum formulas, we're just going to replace them with subtotal functions. The syntax includes function code and a range. The function code is a number that determines what operation the subtotal function will be performing on your data. Number 9, which is for sum, is the one that is most frequently used. So for our formula, what we have to do equal subtotal, then put number 9 for sum, comma, and then we want to specify the range. The ranges will be identical to what we had in our sum function. At the very end, when we want to calculate the grand total, we will also use the subtotal function. So now we're going to say subtotal, then put the code 9 for sum, and then we're going to select the entire range from row 3 to row 20. And you can see that the total is correct. And so what happens is that the subtotal function ignores the other subtotals, so it doesn't double count. Now, I want to show you one more thing to be aware of for both functions, actually. Let's say I have some new healthcare information data and I want to add it to my expenses. So what happens is I move the data here. So in column D, it has the sum function. In column E, it has the subtotal function. So what happens is if I double check my sum grand total, you can see because I manually chose rows before, it's missing the healthcare subtotal. However, in my subtotal function, it works perfectly because it is part of the subtotal range. Now, this worked like that because the healthcare information was inserted in the middle of the data set. However, if I put it at the very end below transportation totals, I would also have to adjust the range for the subtotal. So you want to just double check when you enter new data that the ranges include all the information. Thanks so much for watching.